Hey, welcome. I'm Linus Torvalds, and I started Linux in 1991. And today, you find Linux everywhere. Small embedded devices, supercomputers. This technology allows you to expand into many different.
Every time you use a search engine, stream a movie, or check your social media, you are interacting with a complex system of servers in a distant data center. When you see statistics that almost 89% of websites run on Unix, Unix is a large family of operating systems that work in a similar way. The data shows that within that family, Linux is the powerhouse. It's so dominant that out of all websites in the world, over half run specifically on Linux. This technological empire wasn't built by a giant corporation like Microsoft or Apple. It was built on top of a project started in 1991 by a single 21-year-old university student in Helsinki. So, how did a student's hobby project become the invisible, yet indispensable foundation of our digital world?
Your job to show customers how the PC7300 can solve everyday business problems. How do you do that?
To understand the Linux revolution, you have to see the world before it. In the early 90s, but Unix wasn't a single product, it was a family of systems sold by corporate giants like AT&T, Sun, and HP. They all shared two things in common. They were proprietary, incredibly expensive.
Toivotan teidät tervetulleeksi tähän Linux-käyttöjärjestelmän julkistamistilaisuuteen.
Jonnekin tietokoneen kauppaan, niin kysykää, onko teillä SEU-Unix, niin ne katsoo teitä kysyä ja sanoo, että ei, emme. Itse asiassa paljon helpompi kirjoittaa sille.
So, for students, there was an alternative called Minix. But it was limited. The real change came from one specific piece of hardware, the Intel 386. Linux has evolved into a powerful, user-friendly desktop OS, used by millions every day through versions like Ubuntu. For years, using Linux on a desktop felt like a battle. The main enemy? Terrible hardware support, especially for graphics cards. This fight reached its boiling point with one company.
Nvidia tries to sell chips, a lot of chips, into the Android market. And Nvidia has been the single worst company we've ever dealt with. So, Nvidia, you.
The conflict peaked in 2012. When Linus Torvalds himself publicly called them out in a moment that became legendary. The relentless pressure of the open source community finally achieved the impossible in 2022, as Nvidia began open sourcing its Linux drivers. From a student's hobby, Linux grew to power our entire digital world. And today, in 2025, its long journey is clear.